Hello. Very good afternoon to one and all who has attended the webinar. We are sorry for the delay. So without any further ado, we would be starting this webinar, which is on winning new profitable opportunities designed to value and deliver on target. Before the webinar begins, let me give you a brief introduction about EDS Technologies as well as the presenter for the day with us today. So EDS Technologies Private Limited, which is shortly called as EDS, is the largest CAD, CAM, CAE, PLM, ERP and real-time visual simulation solutions provider in India. So with over 2 decades of experience in various industries, we enable companies in aerospace, automotive and supply chain, industrial machinery, high-tech and electronics, railways, infrastructure, consumer packaged goods, engineering service providers, defense and research verticals to achieve their business goals. We are established in 1995 and are headquartered in Bangalore. The company operates with its direct presence in India in different locations like Chennai, Coimbatore, Gurgaon, Hyderabad, Pune, Mumbai, Kolkata, Noida, Ahmedabad and Nagpur. We have the largest customer database in Indian market in PLM, ERP and visual simulation business and have successfully partnered with more than 1500 customers in various industry verticals. We have established a privileged position in the market and partnered with many global key players like Dassault Systems. And we also provide PLM trainings and trained on-site resources, bringing in the most complete solutions for any size and any type of company. So here with us at the present, we have Mr. Kiran today. He has overall about 8 years experience into PLM solutions and he is with EDS for about 5 years now. So without any further ado, I would be requesting Kiran to take over the webinar and you can always post your queries whenever you want on the chat box. At the end of the webinar, we will be explaining you all the queries in detail. So please hold on with it. Thank you so much. Kiran?
Thank you, Archana. Hi, everyone. So today we will try to know what is about Bit2Win and how Dassault is helping through Bit2Win to the automotive suppliers. So basically when we start any product or any product development, so one company doesn't produce everything. So they depend on their vendors or suppliers or people who can say tier suppliers or tier 1 suppliers or tier 2 suppliers like that. So the one Bit2Win is mainly towards the automotive concept. So basically, automotive try to move the world. So we have different technology which has been incorporated in automotive domain. So automotive is always the technology what they use in automotive is always a vice versa, which is also used in aerospace nowadays. Initially, it was the technology started, automotive technology was started with aerospace concept. And after that, now it is so sophisticated, even that technology is also, they're trying to adopt in aerospace. Like for a small example, if I take F1 race cars, which are so sophisticated, they use so much system engineering and ECUs. So that is a, becomes a technology driven. So we can think about in the normal cars also. Like many of the leading brand cars have the ECU kits in their cars equipped. But going to it, so any car company or any supplier of the car company is always a win-win situation if they are working with their OEMs and OEMs working with their suppliers. So basically, the content which we'll be trying to understand is challenges and objectives and solution introduction and illustrations. So these are the major things. So basically to understand what is exactly this Bit2Win is more a concept than a single license kind of a thing. So in the name itself, we can understand when we bid, we can win it. So that's how it will be. So any business or any supplier business will keep running keep running in a normal way, or only the business is running good, the other technology driving towards that business will always be having interest. So how to improve the business when any of the supplier company, for example, if you are working with a supplier company or if you are a supplier company to any of the automotive, leading brand automotive, like we can take some examples like Volkswagen or GM or some Toyota. So now you wanted to expand your business for other, say for example, you are a supplier for one company and you wanted to leverage your technology or capabilities to the other company. Or if there is any RFQ that you wanted to compete in that RFQ or attend that RFQs and win the bid. So you have to prepare the quotations at the right moment at first time. It is, we cannot delay the time of quotation, and as well as we have to give the accurate information. So we give the less information, it's always a problem for the company, and we have to give precise information. What is the technicalities, what the customer is asking for, whether we have the capability of doing it, or if we have already done that, how much profit we got it, or if our company is a global company, so if where we can produce those components, and if we import, how much it will be costed off. So basically, how is bid-to-win helping in these aspects, and technically how much it is involved, and commercially how much it is involved, and what is the roles of each and every person in the bid-to-win, each and every person in the organization when it comes to bid-to-win as a concept. Now, what are the objectives basically is required for any of the business to grow to the next level, like optimize, enhance, and existing legacy. Say for example, if we are using some legacy method of producing the components or a product, so it is the time it is required to upgrade the machines, to upgrade the processors, to upgrade the systems. So in that sense it is. So and also we also require the legacy data. So why it is, when we say legacy data, it's all experience data, it is basically. So the previously whatever we have experienced, it could be a loss, profit, and as well as it could be the win situation or win lose situation, something like that. So those data is always required for us. Or whether it is leveraged to the next generation, that is important. So how to leverage? Again, when at the time of leverage, we see a lot of people quitting their organization because leveraging the information will not be like one day or two days. It is again a systematic migration of information from one generation to another generation. But the point is, like, we get stuck in some of the other time of transferring the information. So at that time, how we can get out of it? That is one question we get. So this bit-to-win help us. So I'll go in the coming slides, I'll be telling depth of it. So the next point is that extend portfolio, diversify business. As I said, like if at all I am a supplier for car seatings, I can try to go the other interior part of the cars, like steering systems or chassis or some other which is more similar, or a new product development. That's how I can think about my portfolio expansion and all those stuff. So on the globalized business and operations, basically when we are dependent on the concepts like bit-to-win, the entire organization, starting from the shop floor and purchase team and logistics team and design team and finance and as well as it could be sales or anything like that. So everyone will be in the digital world. So no one will be using a paper or like pen kind of stuff basically. So whatever we come across, that will be registered in the digital world. So that for any person, like especially for sales, as a business proposal manager or quotation manager or any representative participating for quotations or bid, so participating for bid, he'll get the accurate information. And when it comes to bit-to-win again, if you are stuck, if your manufacturing unit is stuck or some of the other point, so how people can get help of it. how the legacy data, the experience data, can be used at any point of problem we face day to day. So that's our optimize and extend product development processes. So what happens is, like, say suppose there is a problem in the shop floor regarding the achievement of quality or regarding the achievement of some process, or we have stopped in some point. So the person who was previously was working with project, he has moved out in some other place. He can leverage this information, or if he has made some previously has faced same kind of issue, he can leverage those information in this particular concept. So this concept also involves in social media within the organization, and we can also link out of the organization for external consultant or DESO portfolio expertise. And ensure business health. So the main agenda in the background is always to have a business. When we say build to win, is always towards the business part of it. So when we prepare any quotation for bid, so we need to be accurate about the design information, about the manufacturing, and all the cost for machine, man, and material. So that is important for us to get it. So we always clean this. When we are in the digital world, it is easy for the proposal manager to get all this information. So transform your engineering capabilities. So whatever we have, reasoning capabilities or technical capabilities, so that need to be transformed. As I said, like, the information passing from one level to the other level. So the experience, like 10, 15 years, so whatever there as a constrained information, so that need to be passed to the next generation. So this bit of in help us in doing it. So increase product virtual test and validation upfront. So for example, whether we can also use this bit of in to have a forum kind of a thing within the organization, whether we can, if at all we are doing this as a testing team, whether how much we are at what exactly we are in the level. So whether we can do this, or is there any, if at all I don't want to take it, what is the problem in that? Where our organization stands. So that the develop ready to produce product aligned with production capabilities. So it's basically, so altogether, when we are come across all this optimizing and extending our portfolios, globalizing businesses and all the stuff, it's always the production as well as design, the development activities will also go to the next level of it. So bid to win is meant for basically for five objectives, which we have already seen, that is optimize and extend product development process, and ensure business health, transform your engineering capabilities, increase product virtual test and validation upfront, develop ready to produce product aligned with production capabilities. So basically, when we see bid to win, so once we get the bid or once we win the business, so we already done the mock to preparing the quotations, to preparing the technicalities, whatever the OEM asks. So based on that, we have already done the mock in the bid to win concept. So once we win the business, we can start actual production or actual R&D, whatever it is required. And so basically, when we see in the bid to win, we get one point which I said in the previous slide when I was explaining is about mock. So when we can also see the trial of it, like while preparing the bid only, we can see the trial, and we can give information to each and every department which is required for technical specification, design point of it, how much is the CAD involvement, how much is the manufacturing, how much is the programming of the manufacturing of the product, and what are the machineries, list of machineries. If at all we have some suppliers, how can we leverage the information to them and take out the latest data and all those stuff. So taking out the latest data is always a very good activity or a homework, I can say, in participating in bids, because we may have participated in a bid, the similar product for a different company 6 months back. So in the downtime of 6 months, the product cost may change, or the material what we procure it, that may change or may increase or decrease. So those consideration day-to-day life can be linked in bitumen. And also, when we are linked with the bitumen, we can also link our ERP packages so that we can get the day-to-day activities or day-to-day cost variations and other things. So covering the complete development process. So one is bidding and nomination, plan and define program, product design and development, process design and development, product and process validation, feedback assessment, correction actions. So the entire in this six stages, the entire, if we see that a bid and feasibility review, concept initiation, approval, program approval, prototype, pilot, launch phase. So in this every phase, so the connectivity between the interdepartment is easy when we go with the bid. So for example, if there is any new design or new capabilities or new R&D which we have come across, so there is a metal reduction and the quality of that or the strength of it is improved with a different material. So how is the manufacturing feasibility? So we can easily quick take the decision of it. So it is difficult sometimes to communicate within the organization, especially between the design and the manufacturing. Okay. So to break that or to build that bridge between these two departments, bitumen help us in covering with respect to business portfolio. So which have all the directions towards the business point of it. So there will be no much interaction within the departments. Like it will be between the one department to the other department. So it will be easy for coordination. So this is a diagram, or this is a flow chart, how the supplier is involved and how the OEM is involved. So if you see the left side part of it, there is a line segregation between the supplier and the OEM. So supplier gives a RFQ. RFQ is a request for quotation. So a request for process or product or something like that. So what supplier does is, supplier bid to that RFQ, whatever he got. So that in the background of the supplier, before bidding, the proposal will be taken care by proposal manager. So what are the specifications below the OEM what we have mentioned here. So that specifications, that requirement will be captured by the process manager and he will give to the concerned managers. So once it is given to the concerned managers, the project task will be assigned from him. So based on the specifications, what OEM expecting as an end product and respective managers get as the information within the organization. So based on that, that will be given to the different for different people, like either as a document, PPAP or FMEA or process flow, ABQP. So I'm very sure that like any of these concepts will be followed in supplier, any of the automotive suppliers. So whether I can't come under the ABQP concept or PPAP or FMEA or process flow. So based on that, so the one portion is like, once I get the deliverables, or what are the components and how many parts it is required and all the stuff. So the BOM is prepared, or a CAD e-BOM is created, and the CAD involvement. So we can see the virtually what is the component size, shape and quantity and all the stuff. And like that, we also give from the CAD, we can get two BOMs, that is e-BOM, engineering BOM and M-BOM. So M-BOM is for manufacturing and all process. And we can also, as a bitumen concept, it is when we go for the software level of understanding, bitumen concept involves one CAD tool, that is CATIA, and fabrication and machining is for Delmia, we use it. Simulation, we use Simulia, and electronics and electrical parts, again a CAD, and whatever the catalog standard parts, again it is a CAD, we use it. Source parts, mechanical parts, what are tooling parts, process, and all the stuff. And the entire coordination, and we can, if at all we wanted to give some technical publications, we use 3DVR as a concept. And so where this 8 steps, 10 steps, when we cover all the information, once the proposal is, once the specification is given, and moving to the different process level, and again the portfolio is managed. So now in this particular slide, we have taken a break as an example, and configurations, what type of breaking it is. So such kind of configuration information, and we can create one CAD model of it. And if there is any catalog which is used, like if at all we using any standard products, or which is also we are sourced to our suppliers, so those things can also be seen. And how much involvement of electrical, if it is some, if I take an example of car seating, so you'll be having a electrical wire harness in the, so for to understand the seat belt sensors, to understand the recliner and lumbar support and all the stuff. So basically those electrical, how much is the harness that is required and all the stuff. Simulation of it, and for whether there is any tooling involved in the simulation for manufacturing of that part. So that is also part of it. And fabrication and embalm creations and processes. Now what happens is the entire manufacturing or design unit will get the information about the whatever the RFQ or RFP we have received from the OEM. Okay. From the proposal manager or business manager. And the project quality and program intelligence and sourcing standardization, product engineering, electronic and electrical product performance, fabrication machining, advanced product engineering, mold and tool and process planning. So the coordination between all these departments, it gets easier when we go with the bitumen. So what are the potential benefits targeted? It's objectives and benefits. Optimize and extend the product development process. How to optimize that benefits we get it? So as I said, like everything gets centralized and digitized. So whatever the information we get it, or whatever the information what a customer is seeking from a supplier, based on the specification and the technicality, if I take an example. So what, how can I optimize that? And how can I extend my product development to the next level? So when we do as a mock, once we submit those information and we still have a time till we win that bid. So till then we can do some homework in the background, understand the technical specification and try to improve the present scenario and other things. The other thing is to increase product portfolio development planning efficiency and quality. That's how you get the benefit. That's how we try to optimize the within the organization once we have proposed any RFQ. So Brano groups, they have utilized this particular bid to win concept, and proposal projects time reduced by 50% and number of projects to bid on increased by 25%. It's obvious it is. So we know that. So anything which is left out in the paper, that may get destroyed sometime. But anything which is left as a digital, it can be used for many times and it will not get destroyed. So that's how the world is changing, and that's how the way of thinking should be changed to understand the business, or if at all we want it to grow globally. So when we say, suppose we are an Indian supplier for Indian cars, or I wanted to go to the next level, or one step next, like I want to participate any of the RFQs globally. How it is possible? So the one is they have their own standard of understanding, standard of company chart or hierarchy of the company, how it is and who is it, who it is and all those stuff. When it is digitalized, it is easy to any head of the company to understand where we are exactly, how we can improve the process. What is the, propose some process, what is the feedback I get it from? So this forum helps such kind of questions to answer. Endurance, so translation to 100% digital and eliminated insufficient paper-based methods. So as I said, it's one example. So where they used this such kind of sophisticated technology to improvise their present scenario. So nowadays we are always with the social media kind of thing, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and WhatsApp, and other things. This between help us within the organization have our own forums. As a general forum, we can also have it, or specific to our groups, we can have it. For example, design or manufacturing or some other thing like that. So post production engineering changes cut by 30%. So that's how it is. So once the bid is done and we already done the mock, how it is, because the RFQ and what are the respective managers have got the information, what is the technicality, what is their involvement. While bidding only, we'll be telling what are the processes involved in manufacturing each and every component. And meantime, when we, at the time of this thing, or we have a lead time, at that time, can we improve the process? So it is definitely, this company has used this and they've improved 30% in the post-production. So a new part creation reduced by 10 minutes, make a potential savings of 6,000 hours per year. So we have already done a mock and we can see. So this is one, it's again a post-production activities. So how we can increase the or reduce the lead time. So 10 minutes in one particular process or one particular product coming out, it has been reduced. It's a huge, huge time saving. So what happens basically is documents, management requirements, and managers. So, and deliverable based project management and predefined APQP templates and failure mode effective analysis, starter kit. So these things which is have inbuilt as a, you get through Innovia, where you can create your own templates like APQP or PPAP or anything which we use it, or FMEA, failure mode and effective analysis. So these things, risk management and highlighting the critical discussions, so and decision makings, it becomes faster when you digitize like this. So the project and quality management also goes towards the achieving in the higher number than the lower number. So sometimes what happens, the organization is doing good and we have the we consider the organization is doing good and good technicality, manufacturing and everything. But only the problem is the documentation part of it. And as well as the coordination or project management or project planning within the organization and the system building and all the stuff. So at that time, we can use in the background Innovia helping us, which is called as a product lifecycle management. It is a part of any of the concepts of Dassault systems, I can say, where it talks about what information need to be given to whom and how much the authority or security or where that person can use it and how much he can involve in it. So such kind of product lifecycle management. And the other thing is, like, you can create EC, engineering change order, engineering change request, based on the whatever the feasibility, whether it is 20% of the present model changes, or 30% of the present model changes, or 70% of the model changes. So though, depending upon the variant, if at all I wanted to go with a new variant, I can take up the decision, it's faster. And the other part is, like, our 3D experience bid to win, which comes under transport and mobility concept. So basically this bid to win also involve the dashboard capabilities and 3D swim community creation. And when we say dashboard capabilities, there are net wipes are used in the background. So whatever the analytics we have done, for example, there is some analytics between some time, some days, or some period. So that those analytics we can get it. Or is there any downstream we have done some mistakes? So how to go towards that mistake and understand how what solutions need to be provided to overcome that mistakes, and as well whether it is repetitive or it is inevitable or it is a new mistakes, how to rectify it in the shop floor or design level or logistics level or purchase level or something like that. Based on each and everything, so we can rely on this pit-to-win concept. So as the business drives, so what happened is like everyone is in the digital system. So it is easy for any business proposal manager or a business manager to get the information faster and rely on the information 100% and fill to those RFQs whatever we get it from the OEMs. That's how we can win the confidence when we are digitalized. And any information that is required at the time of quotation generation, we can quick connect with the different departments. So that is possible when we are a digital link. So enforce standardization, drive full reuse and makeover. So enablers, one part reduce, one part reuse, one part supply. So classify multi sources and publish enterprise catalog. So sourcing and one part use, search similar parts to a string or a shape and analyze all related information. One part supply, rebuild engineering characteristics for the market and source information. So XR lead, as I said, you can do a comparison between if you have the same cross section and the length of the component is changing and where and all it is used. So you can see in the second column. So here you can see that this person is trying to make the comparison between each and every. It's like I can say 3D search. And I can also do the comparison between. So where and all it is used, those information can also be easy to get. So automated standardization to reduce the drastically number of parts, increase the reuse up to 90% to control project margin and profit and effort, provide earlier sourcing info to enable designers to make smart choices. So this is the background of it, and that's how it will help us in business drivers. Consolidating enterprise and engineering data, the 3D product engineer, web page configuration, multi-CAD, DMU powered by. So our engineers, our business proposal manager can also use that. Unified chain management, one unified POM and CAD, chain management process, data exchange, manage exchange with several OEMs, CAD versions. So this is a bigger hurdle when we go for a data exchange. So where our 3D experience bit of in help us in doing this. So that is connectors we can. We have a lot of connectors. So for different products, for different algorithms or CAD algorithms we are using. So those we have a connectors. So irrespective of any of the CAD, we can link and make it this particular product or concept as a data exchanging for it. So what are the potential benefits targeted? Like we saw a few examples like that. We have Jaguar Land Rover. So ensure business health to prevent the risk and anticipate the deviations to take proactive and informed corrective actions. So basically they could remove the Excel and instant access to data anytime, any place, anywhere. So those concepts they have used and they have improvised their present system. And Tesla, accelerate business decision, enable to save time and improve vehicle quality. So Tesla had some issue, some regarding their car charger inside the car. So they did not call back any cars. So they asked the consumers to connect to their Wi-Fi, and they have updated the software. So that's how you can save the customer time and company's time also when you are interlinked. When you make such kind of sophistications within the organization, and you can also suggest this to your suppliers. Even real-time information to make proactive decisions. So this is what I was talking about. If I have some information, how will I present it? I need not to spend time in preparing the PPTs, presentations, or Excel, big Excel, and different parts and all that stuff. So here I can get all the information as a presentable. This through happening with NetWise and Excel leading the background. So this will again improve, or within the organization, reduces the communication less. Everything is in the presentable format. So that will help the business drivers to submit to the area of the RFQ. So what are the potential benefits targeted based on this objective and the benefits? Transform your engineering capabilities to enable more innovation within development process with the new technologies. So NGK spark plug design reconfiguration accelerated by using modular design capabilities. Control of design information is unified. And recon commissioning time at the customer site reduced by 50% and improved design productivity by 30%. And HVAC supplier 3D printing solutions improve efficiency, reducing drastically development cycle and production cost. So this is Renault-Nissan. Even with the data center in France, Korea, engineers have an average 8% difference to load, modify, or save their data compared to France. So the new way of design to foster innovation, that is 3D product engineering and also functional generative design. So we can see the different sheet metal component involved, casting and forging involved, and machine parts are involved, plastic parts are involved, and mechatronics. Obviously, nowadays, if you see, so a lot of automotives are involved with all these kind of facilities. So for different expertise, we get a different technicalities and as well as their commercials, which will help any of the business leaders to fill the of the RFQs. What are the potential benefits targeted by this? Realizes up to 25% time saving in their computer aided engineering projects, and ensure the reliability of critical supercharger components with efficiency. So there is Emilia involved in this. Yamaha simulation is an effective means of identifying locations for shred countermeasures and for developing new and more effective designs. So potential benefits targeted. So aggregated information of all planning domains and optimizing workplaces. And for sure, so integration between the engineering and manufacturing forms for planning. And OEM, automated documentation generation for milling machine operators. So increased manufacturing flexibility for order fulfillment. So the digital plant layout, so to understand the how much is the lead time we are taking, and how can we increase the productivity, or towards the digital plant level, process planning optimization, and 3D instructions. 3D instructions where we use CATIA, Composer, or 3D VR, I can say. So this will not only help us in going for such kind of facilities, which will also give us information freedom or information to take decision which comes with the freedom again. So whether it is correct or not, and whether if I am putting to proposal, whether it is correct, or how much, what is the, you know, what if there is any small changes in the RFQ or specific specifications, technical specification, how quick I can reach to each individual. So that will help overall in improvising, and as well as and simulation with respect to digital plan, process planning, and ready work, etc. So that's all for the day. So I hope this session was useful. And please let me know if you have any queries. You are free to ask me now, or you can reach us to www.edstechnologies.com, marketing.edstechnologies.com, or you can reach kiran.plr@edstechnologies.com to for any four of the technicalities you wanted to know. Or it will be useful, it will be help. So if at all if you want help to a specific query or a specific solution you're looking for through Bit2Win, if you're automotive supplier, please call us. So we can say that, like, if you have a problem, we have a solution, kind of a thing. So we can help you with the background. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for the day.
Thank you so much, Kiran. Thank you so much for the detailed technical presentation on Bit2Win to win the new profitable opportunities and target. The attendees, if you have any other queries, you can always write to us at marketing@edstechnologies.com, or you can write directly to me or Kiran Wimbox, which is archinal.plr@edstechnologies.com, or Kiran, kiran.plr, which stands for Bangalore, @edstechnologies.com. So we would be more than happy for you to help and to answer your queries. If you need any other technical demos which has to be demonstrated and to have more idea about the solution, we can always arrange our technical team to discuss about it with you. So I hope you had a great time, and I hope the session was useful to us. Please let us know if there are any queries or any sort of clarity to be needed.